Data stores in Roblox can be pretty hard to set up. So, you can probably see over here that there's this folder. And I'm gonna show you how to make a saving data store system. Everything will work, and it'll probably only take a couple minutes. You can make inventories, save stats, whatever. You can make a level up system. You can make basically anything save that's that you would generally need for a game. The thing that might take the longest here is just installing a plugin. So that is in the that's the link in the description. Also read the dev forum post if you want more information about it. But I'm just going to show you the basics in this video. So when you've installed the plugin, close Studio and then open it up again. And once it asks for the it'll probably ask for permission to manage scripts. So once you tick that, then relaunch Studio again, and then you'll have this folder here. So inside it, there should be all these values. Welcome badge, obviously, welcome badge, data name, that's just what the data thing's called. Data key, it's the player's user ID, custom data key. I might show this later. This one's a bit more complicated, but everything else is really easy. So in player, actually right here, in server storage I have potions. And let's say I want the player to be able to have a potions inventory. So I'll insert a folder, and I'll just have it called potions inventory. And if I want to make this an inventory, then I'll add a string value and call it is inventory. Now, all the information is in this information thing. This is actually an old script, so this isn't the full information, because there's an update right now. But you can see that these are all the value names. So what we want right here is the clone of the values, because I want it to save the duration and multiplier. Now, this is kind of important. If you don't want it to save a value, like the description or the required level for something, just put a value inside of it called no save. It doesn't have to be a string value, I don't think, but that's what I always use, so it might have to be. I don't really remember. So we want to save all this, so we're gonna make it clone with values, and just make the values of inventory of in is inventory clone with values. Now, you also have to make sure there's a value like that's inside of it called clone folder name, and the value of that will be whatever the value's called or whatever the folder's called. The folder has to be inside server storage, like directly. So it's just called potions, so I'll copy that name, put it in here, and now the potion inventory is working. That's it. If I want to store a level, I'll just make it an int value. It can't be a double constrained value, by the way. I've never seen anybody use them, but it can't be that. I can't store those. So here's level. Now I'm going to do EXP. Okay, start at level 1. And whatever the value is the default. EXP is 0, and let's just say a string value. Character name. Why not? And the default is just nothing, I guess. So, all right. This is all done. That's it. But there's one thing. Click on the apply value over here, and then just click on this box to apply it. See, it'll say applied. And it'll make a script inside here. You don't actually have to read this script, but it has everything working inside of it. This is the script. So you don't actually need that. But if you would like, see how it works, you can do that, I guess. Now, if I hit play, I'll just change all the values to what they were. 5 exp, and character name. There we go. So now if I stop it, and I go back in and hit play, right there, there. So now I'll switch to the server side, player, potion inventory, see, jump potion, speed potion 2, there we go. Jump potion, same duration, same multiplier. Speed potion, a duration of 5, and multiplier of 10. That's what I set it to. Now, if I go to my EXP, there's 5, and my level's 5, my character name is Trisodin. So that's how you use the plugin. A bit of extra information. You can end the video now if you want, but just a bit of extra information if you want it. Is you can put other folders. It doesn't have to be an inventory. So if I just want to have player stats, there we go, and then I put in this inside of it. So another thing you can do, you can have folders inside folders, but I don't care about that. There's other things for is inventory. So the create value, it actually has all the instruction script. You can read this, but basically, create value will store values as an inventory. So if you just want a list of bool values for like a tycoon or something, you could have that. Clone by name will clone. It'll clone just from the name, so it won't save any values inside of it. Clone value is the one that we just did, and one more thing is that your inventories can only store. Right now, if it's clone with values or clone by name, it can only store folders or tools. That's it. That might expand later on, I'm not sure. I probably will. And another thing is if you use clone with values or you're just doing these, it can only store, it says right here, it stores ints, strings, booleans, and numbers. That's all there is to store. That's basically everything data store can store anyways. It can also store dual constrained values. Not this, though. And just a quick thing before I end the video. If you actually want a double constrained value, you can't save it in this, by the way. But you just go instance.new, double constrained. I know I want autofill, but it works. It's not dual constrained value, but I always call it that. Double constrained value, workspace, or something. And then inside the workspace, you can see we have value, double constrained value, minimum, maximum, and then the value. So there's that. But you probably won't need that very much, but it's a useful thing to know. Anyways, I hope this helped with your making your game and not having to go through the pain of making a data store system. You might still have to script it yourself if you're wanting to do things like level publishing system, like what I have in Hobby Lobby, or anything that's complicated that's not just stats or inventory. Even guilds, you can probably do a way to have, you can probably make a way to have guilds with this, but I don't know, like, how you do that. So you'd probably also need to script it yourself for guilds. But for basically everything else, this will work for, and it'll just make it a lot easier. So I hope this helped save you some time, and I guess if you have any questions or suggestions, ask in the comments or on the dev forum post, and I may or may not make another video on this. Okay.